Whenever a condition is met, whenever a condition is met, I want to modify the value of a record. I want to say if the status is approved, then update rating equal to what. Whenever the value of status is changed to approved, then automatically update rating equal to what. Whenever industry value is modified as banking, automatically update the field ownership equal to private. So you want some updation to happen automatically at the back end. You want the value of the field to be modified automatically at the back end, which we are calling as field update. Whenever a condition is met, automatically the value of the field need to be modified by the system, which we are giving as field update, which we are giving as workflow field update. So let us look at this condition. When you want to update the field, which fields you can update? You can update field of my record, or you can update my master record field. You can update my field, or you can update my master record field. So first let us see how to create a field update. Setup, build, create, workflows and approvals. Then we have, look at this. What was this? Go to the field update, new field update. Rating update. On which object you are creating this update? Record. Right. Then which field you want to update? I want to update then what is the value. So on account we are creating an action. What is this action? On this account we are trying to create an action. On this account we are trying to create an action. What is this action? Rating is modified as hot. This is the action. Are you getting my point here? This is the action. So how are you creating? Setup, build, create, workflows and approvals. Then we have build. On account, which field, ownership. Ownership is modified. Like this, we have created some field update action. This action need to be added to what? Workflow rule. So what I am doing, setup, build, create, workflows and approvals, workflow. Then we had new rule on which object? Account. Next, corporate customer created. I'm giving a condition. What is the condition? If account type equal to, if account type equal to prospect, account type equal to prospect, then perform the action. What is the action we are performing? What we have? I can create a new field update here, or else I can add any one of the existing action. So what is the existing action? I already created an action called, I can create a new update action there, or choose one of the existing update action. Then click on done. Click on activate. Click on done. Click on activate. then go to the account, go to the account, then go to the new account. Type equal to prospect. When type equal to prospect, automatically what happened? Rating equal to hot. Automatically rating equal to hot. So whenever the condition is met, automatically we have performed field update action, modifying the value of any one of the record, modifying the value of any one of the field. Whenever the condition is met, we are trying to modify the value of a record, which is called field update. Any query on this? Are you clear about this? When the condition is met, modify this action. I hope everyone has followed this example. Now let us go to the next one. Here, when you are performing a field update action, we had some issues here. What was the issue? First, the basic concept is clear. What was that? Whenever the condition is met, we are trying to change the value of a particular field. Now look at my issue. I have a lead. In the lead, I am creating the action. Create field updates. New field update. Created first on lead, update description. Update the description. What is the description? This is action one. So I have created this. Then I'm going for a workflow rule. Build, create, workflow rule, new workflow rules. On lead object, lead multiple. What was the condition I'm giving? When lead is created or modified, if rating equal to hot, if rating equal to hot, perform the action. Action field update. Second action. Right, one action is added. This is second action. Then add one more action. Now there are multiple actions added to the same workflow rule. Now which action will run first? Which action will run first? Now look at this point. If created first is running, this is created, let us say 11:05 created. What is the action? This is, both the actions has to run. What is the second one? Second action. So let us say 11. Right, boss. These are the actions. How they are added to the rule? Workflow. How they are added to the workflow rule? Second is added first. Then we added first. If they are running as per the order of created date, if the actions are running as per the created date, then what will happen? First description. This is first action. Then second action will run, which will modify the value as this is second action. Output will be this is second action. No, they are not running based on the created date. They are running based on order in which we are adding. To the workflow rule, which is added first, second action is added first. Then followed by first action. No, if they are running as per the created date, first this will run, followed by this will run. So output will come as this is second action. No, they are not running as per the created date. They are running as per the order in which they are added. Then what happened? Second will run first. This is. Then first will run. Then what happened? This is. So looking at the output, we can say when you have multiple actions added to the same workflow rule, when you have multiple actions added to the same workflow rule, what is the order in which the actions are going to run? What is the order in which the actions are going to run? There is only one action, no problem. If multiple actions are added to the same rule, what is the order in which they are going to execute? Is it as per the order of action created date, or is it as per the order of action added? So go back to this. I hope everyone received my requirement. Then go to the lead. Choose any one of the lead. Rating is modified. It's already hot. What is the value of description? Now, condition is not met. Where is the description value? Condition is not met. Now, what is the value here? Warm. Which I am changing as hot. When I change to hot, then. This is second update. So if you are getting this is second update, what is the order of action? As per the order of action created date. When you have multiple workflow rules, when you have workflow rule with multiple actions, when you have multiple field update action for the same workflow rule, we have workflow one, we have workflow one, okay, workflow one with the two actions. So when you have multiple actions for the same rule, actions will be executed as per the order of action created date. I hope you got my point. Clear? One rule, more number of action. Now if we have rule 1, rule 2. This is only one workflow rule, two different action. Now let us take the next scenario. What is my next scenario? Everyone has followed this point. Everyone has followed this point. What was the rule here? When you have multiple actions for the same workflow rule, what is the order of their execution? Now let us take the next one. So look at this. Now I'm trying to create build, create workflows and action. Again, listen to this. Listen carefully, boss. Workflow. First workflow, City equals to Hyderabad. Then, what is the action we are adding? Select existing. Rule 1, action 2. Then again, workflow 2. Now, what we have done? Rule 1. Second action, it was created 11:30. Rule 2. Learn 15. This rule was created at 12. Right. Now, when you have multiple rules on a same object, rule 1 has action 1, rule 2 has action 2. Now, when you have multiple rules on the same object, which action will run? As per the workflow created date or as per the order of action created date. If it is a workflow created date, if it is a workflow created date, which will run first? Second action will run. This become, this is second action. Then this will be modified as first action. This will run first because it is created at 12 o'clock. This is created at 13. So this will be changed as, this is first action. No, actions will be working on action created date. Let the workflows be created at any time, but the actions will be performed as per the action created date. Then which action is created first? First action. This is first action. Then second action will run. So this become, now looking at the output, we can say, are the actions are performed as per the workflow created date or as per the order of action created date. When there are multiple workflow rules on the same object, then how the actions will be performed? Is it as per the order of workflow created date or is it as per the order of action created date? Go back to this. Go to the lead. Validation rules. New record is created. What is the description we are getting? This is action. This is action 1 means how they are running? As per the order of workflow created. Right? Now let us take the conclusion clearly. First, let me remove the validations on this. Every time we are getting these errors actually. Now, let us be very clear on this one. Now I have action 1. Action 1 created. What is that? So rating equal to, these are the two actions. Now I have workflow one. What is that workflow one? If industry equal to banking, then actions, action one. These are the actions which are added. Now, how this I create a record ICICI. Now, what is the output of this? One workflow rule, two actions. What is the output of this? When there are two workflow, when there is a workflow rule with the two actions, actions will be performed as per the order of action created date. Which action was created first? 10:30. So it will be modified as hot. Then followed by second action. What is second action? So when you have workflow rule with multiple action, actions will be performed as per the order of action created date. I hope you are good. The same one I had. Workflow one. Industry equal to banking. Ownership equal to this rule, workflow rule is created on 10:30. You have two workflow rules with their corresponding action. When you have multiple workflow rules, how the actions will be performed? Now, what is the output I have got? I got here. Now, what is the output? If it is a single workflow rule, multiple action, actions will be performed as per the order of action created date. If you have multiple workflow rules, actions will be performed as per the order of workflow rules. Now, what is the workflow rule which created first? Okay, rule one. So, what is the rule one action? Rating equal to warm. Then followed by rule two. Rating equal to hot. What is the output we are going to get? Wipro banking hot. Are you getting my point? Right? So, right. Still not done. We have a few more points to discuss. Listen carefully, Amma. This is two major points. Listen carefully, everyone. I have workflow rule number 1, city equal to Hyderabad, action. Rule created August 10th. Action was created. August 3rd. Rule number 2. Created on August 11th. City equal to two workflow rules are there. Now look at the format. I created a record, the pro Hyderabad. Now how they are going to run? If you say this will run first followed by this, then what happened? City equal to Hyderabad, then automatically reading will change to hot. If reading is hot, this will not be true. Suppose this is running first, rating equal to warm, then make the city equal to Bangalore, then this will not run. So when you have multiple workflow rules defined on the same object, how they will run? They will run like this. First, all the rules will be verified. What happened? Workflow 1. Is city equal to Hyderabad? Workflow 2. Is reading equal to warm? Yes. So are they performing rule and action? No. Rule 1, rule 2, rule 3, rule 4, like that. All the rules are verified. Rule 3. Then verify the rule number 3. When you verify the rule number 3, city equal to Chennai. So I verified all the rules. After verifying all the rules, whichever the rules are true, collect their actions. Whichever the rules are true, collect their action. So verify all the rules at a time. After verifying all the rules, whichever the rules are true, collect their actions. So what is the action? Collect their action. And their actions are performed as per the order of rule created date. Which rule was created first? So collect their actions. What are the actions we have? Workflow 1, city equal to. Workflow 2, equal to. Now, after verifying all the rules, whichever the rules are true, collect their action. Run the actions as per the order of workflow rule created date. As per the order of workflow rule created date. Then how the actions will be performed? First, which rule is created first? 10th August. So perform this. When you perform this, the output will be Wipro. I was supposed to make here. Okay, what is the action? Rating equal to hot. Then action 1 is performed. After performing this, perform the second action. What is the second action? Rating equal to. What was the second action I gave? Workflow 1, I gave reverse, right? Slight mistakes I made. I was supposed to give rating equal to hot and city equal to. Then city equal to. What is the final output we are getting? Wipro Bangalore. What was this? When you have multiple workflow rules, check all the rules first. Check all the rules first. Now out of this, whichever the rule is true, collect their actions. After collecting their actions, run those actions as per the workflow rule created date. So what we have? Workflow 1 action, workflow 2 action. Out of this, you are supposed to run them as per the order of workflow rule. As per the order of workflow rule created date. Which rule was created first? August 10th at 10:30. So what is the action? Rating equal to hot. Then second, then third. Are you clear about this? Now, is it rule action? No. What is the order? All the rules. Check all the rules on the same record. Then which of them are true? Run their actions as per the order of workflow rule created date. Workflow rule created date. Pardon me. Action is city equal to Bangalore. No. If city equal to Hyderabad, rating equal to hot. What is the action we are making, boss? Rating equal to hot. So what happened? Wipro Hyderabad warm is modified as Wipro Hyderabad hot. Then what is the second action? City equal to Bangalore. Then what happened? Wipro Hyderabad hot is the record. On that, we are modifying again. Already one action is performed. Second action we are modifying. So Hyderabad is modified as Bangalore. We have, first I told this guy to modify, then followed by this guy. So whenever he modified, after his modification, he is going to modify. Both the changes will be there on the record. I hope you are good with this. Right, boss? So what was the condition? When you have multiple workflow rules defined on the same object, check all the rules first. After checking all the rules, whichever the rules are true, perform their actions as per the order of workflow rule created date. I hope you are good with this. Clear? Let us go to the next one. Let me put all these points first. When a condition is met, you want to system to update the value. Using the field update, fields of a record and its master. Steps to create action. How did you create? Setup, build, create, field update. Choose the object. Enter action name. Choose the object. Choose the field. Choose the field. Set the value. Example 1. Example 1. Object. Object. Field. Action name. Field update action. Then I create a workflow. What is the workflow? Full name. Then choose the object. What is the object you have chosen? Object, what is the object you have chosen? Rule. Created. Rule. What is the rule? Lead source equal to action. Choose from. Existing. What is the existing action you want to choose? Rating update. Click on activate. Basic example. So now, how do you test it? Lead source as and check the this is first basic level one basic example with a field update action. Okay, so whenever the new lead is created with the lead source equal to web, automatically what happened? Rating value will be modified as hot. Rating value will be modified as. So let us take the next example. What is the next point we had? When you have workflow rule with multiple action. When we have workflow rule with multiple field update action. When you have workflow rule with multiple field update action, then actions. Field update actions will be executed in the order of field update actions will be executed in the order of action field update action created date. When you have workflow rule with multiple field update action, then field update actions will be executed in the order of field update action created date. So field update action object. Object account. Then field description value. What is the value? This is updated with the first action. Same story I'm repeating. Field update action 2. That was created on 14th August. This is the first action created was on 10th. Second action was created on 14th. Second action. Then we are creating a workflow rule. Create a workflow rule. Rule name. Actions. Object. Object is account. Evaluation created. Evaluation criteria created. Then rule. Action add the existing actions order of now we have workflow rule with two actions. One workflow rule with the two actions. Then what we are supposed to do? Open, click on account tab. Get new account. Save the record. Then what will happen? Output will be output pro banking dot. What is the second action we had? This update with because first action is performed, then followed by second action. Whatever the changes that are made by the second action, they'll be final. So what is the output we got? This update with the second action. First, the first update has happened, that was modified by second update. I hope you are good with this, because both are trying to perform the modification on the same field. If you take a different field, you cannot tell which is running first. If you take the same field, then you can tell which field is, which action is running first. That is the reason I have taken the same field update. If you take a different fields, you will not be able to tell, you will not be able to track which field is, which action is getting performed first. Now, what is the order of their execution? As per the action created date. Which action was created first? 10th August. Do this, followed by put in the list. So the final output will be this. Right, boss? Now, what is the next rule we have? Workflow rule will created with the multiple workflow rules with the multiple actions. Multiple work. This is one workflow rule with the multiple action. Next one is what? When we have on the same object, actions will be performed as per the order of workflow created date. The next one, when we have multiple workflow rules, defined on the same object, all the rules are verified first. Then their actions are performed. As per the workflow look at the example. Workflow 1, name of the workflow, create a date, August. Then which object? Object account. Action. Choose from, what did you choose? Workflow, same story,
method.
So the three rules, three workflow rules are created 10th August. Then just it. Click on account tab, create a new account. So we had Wipro. Banking. This is the record what I created. When you create this record, execution is what? This record. So on this record, check all the rules. Step 2, collect the actions of those rules. Chart. What are they? Action. Run the actions as per the order of action workflow created. So which workflow is created first? First one. What is the action they gave? Action 2. What is action 2? What is action 2? This is second update followed by, this will be coming like pro. First run action. After this, then run second. Pro banking. So what is the output we are going to get? So this is the final output we are going to get. See, if you take a single workflow rule field update, no need to have this discussion. If you take only one field update, no need to have this discussion. We have taken a first example, value is modified, action is completed. But practicality is, when you get into the real time, there is a group of rules which will be running on this. Now you need to know which will dominate. What will be the outcome of the rule? When I have four rules running on the same record, which will run first? Which will give the finally what will be the output of this. Based on that, other things will run. There is a reason we are insisting in knowing what is the order of their execution. Okay. Next important point. Listen very carefully. Next important point here. We are looking at Listen carefully, boss. Everyone, listen carefully. At the time of creating a workflow rule, there is one option. Workflow rule field update, there is one action. Create workflow rules, field updates. What was this? Re-evaluate workflow rule on field update. So this is very important point. Listen carefully. Workflow rule one. Rule says if city equal to Hyderabad, action. Now we had workflow number 2. Yes. Rating equal to hot. Right. So these are two workflow rules. There are two workflow rules. Listen carefully, boss. What is the purpose of that statement? Re-evaluate workflow rule after field changes. Okay. Now I am creating a record. I am creating a record. Wipro Hyderabad. This is the record what I created. This is the record what I created. Now I have this record here. Now if you look at this record, when there are multiple workflow rules, what will happen? Check the rules. All the rules will be verified. Workflow 1. City equal to Hyderabad, S2. We have workflow 2. What is the rule number 2? Rating equal to hot. So 1 is true, 2 is false. Workflow 1, workflow 2. Workflow 1, workflow 2. There are two rules. Then, out of these two, whichever is true, that is taken. What is the rule? What is the action we need to perform? Update, right? So first rule already verified, second rule it is a false. Second rule already verified, it is a false. Am I right? Now if I recheck the rule, it will be true. Now already verified, it is a false. Rule number 1 is true, action is performed. If I recheck the rule, if I recheck the second rule, now second rule will be true. Am I right or wrong? After updating because of the rule number 1, workflow rule number 1 modified the data. Now if I check the rule, it will be true. But can I check the rule or not is the question. Now once again if I check the rule, it will be true. But are you allowed to check the rule or not is the question. workflow rule says, boss, once you verified it is a false, you cannot check. Once you verified, did you verify the rule? Yes. Is it true? No. That's the end of the operation. But I want to check the rule again. Then what will I do? I will enable this option. If I enable this option, what will happen? Because of the workflow rule number one, if there is any change in the value, of a record, then cross-check remaining rules which are failed. Which rules are failed? Workflow number 2 is failed. Cross-check now. Once again, when you check, then perform the action. Cross-check the action. What is the action we had? Wipro. Acrobat. This one. What is the output we had? Wipro, Hyderabad, Hot, Public. Wipro, Hyderabad, Hot, Public. I hope you are clear with this. Wipro, Hyderabad, Hot, Public. Now, if I enable this also, then if there is any modification because of the rule number 2, if there are any failed rules, cross check. But are there any failed rules? Rule will be verified only once, and if it is true, it will not cross check again. So what is the purpose of this? Re-evaluate means, because of this workflow rule, if there is any field update on the record, cross check the remaining rules which are failed in the earlier step. Are you clear about this? People followed? If I don't check this, what happened? All the rules are verified. Whichever is true, run them, stop. If I enable this option, cross-check all the rules, whichever is true, run the operation. After running the operation, if there is any false, failed rules, cross-check them again. After updating the field, recheck the rules again. I hope you are good. I hope you are good with this. Now come back to the process. What was the condition? Re-evaluate the workflow rule on workflow rules after field changes. What was this? If this option is enabled, if there are any field updates due to the workflow rule, if there is any field update due to the workflow rule, it will recheck the remaining rules. It will recheck the remaining rules which are It will recheck the remaining rules which are failed in the earlier steps. I hope everyone has got this step. I'll give one use case for your practice. Cross check this. I'll give one use case, cross check. If this condition was clear, if this is enabled. Will update. Action one. What is the object? Object one, account. Field ownership equal to. Then reevaluate. Make it false. Object. This is what we have created. Now create a workflows. Workflows, I'll just copy the existing action boss. Then first action. Then I have industry equal to banking. Then what is the action I have to perform? Action one. If rating equal to hot, action two. Now if rating equal to hot, ownership equal to private. So if industry equal to banking, action one, which says ownership equal to private. Workflow two, then we have ownership equal to private, do this. Now testing. Create Wipro banking. So I have created a record. Name industry. This is the format in which I created. Then, once you create, what will be the output? What is the output we are going to get? What is the output we are going to get, boss? Wipro banking. Because the second rule is not going to run. Is it going to cross check the rule? No. So what I am doing now, go to action one and enable, go to action one and enable, reevaluate. Enable reevaluate workflow. Then create a test record. Same record I'm creating again. Then what is the output? Now the second rule will run because you told re-evaluate. Output is going to be then the second rule also verified. Why? Because I told re-evaluate. First time I created, second rule is not checked. Because already I verified it, it's false. If it is false, stop it. But when I enable it, even though it's false, recheck the rule again, and if it is true, perform it. After every time I modify the value of a record, recheck. If it is still true, perform the action. I hope you are good with this. This is a key points in field update. Apart from the regular field update action, these are the possible errors or combination which may give, okay, which may raise issues while you are working with a group of actions. If you are practicing with one rule, you will not get any issue. When you are practicing with one rule, one field update, no issue at all. When there is a group of actions you are performing, then a combination is going to give you, okay, different format of output than what you are deserving. Then how to check it? These are the key points which you have to take into consideration while working. Okay. See, no, you're mistaken. Workflow 1 is already true, right? Workflow 1 you verified is already true. That's the end of the game. Leave it. Leave it. Now, workflow 1 is already true. When you make an action, workflow 1 is true, then perform the action. That is the end of the workflow 1. Now, workflow 1 is not in action anymore. Only the remaining rules which are fail are in action. Now, one rule will be true only once. It is true, leave it. Mm-hmm. Okay. See, when I say all the rules which are failed, did I say order of first rule, one will check only two, two will check only three? I told when your rule is true, when you made a change, all the rules which are failed will be rechecked. When you say all the rules, all the remaining rules which are failed. If workflow 2 is true, workflow 1 is false, workflow 2 is true, right? Then field update is made. If you enable this option, see, simple one, you are making a khichdi. I'll make it very simple, funda. If rule is there, workflow rule, now if it is say re-evaluate, if that rule is true and it has modified the value of the field, then you will check all the rules which are failed. That's all, as simple as that. If my rule is true, if I am making any changes on the field, on the record, then it will recheck all the remaining rules which are failed once again. Now ask your question. All rule means everything, na? I have taken 1,000 rules. Now 1,000 is true, remaining all 999 is false. Then what will happen? When I say all rules are rechecked, you are asking a specific one. I told all. All means it's everything which are failed. All the rules which are failed. If it's already true, it will not check. Right. Any other queries on this? Good. Right. Implement the use cases to get the better understanding of this functionality. Okay. Let us go to the next action. What is the next action? Email update action. Now, what is this email update action? Boss, I want to perform an action by sending an email. People are saturated. Saturated? No problem. We can take one more example. Right. Let us go to the next one. So, email updates. Now, what is this? When a rule is true, you want to send an email notification. When the rule is true, I want to send an email notification. If you want to send an email notification, first you have to have an email template. Every time I will not type the letter. Now, ICICI Bank will type every letter, dear customer Satish, your credit card bill for the month of June 21st to July 21st is this bill. Are they going to type it? No, right? So what is that? It's a predefined template. Everybody will get the same format. Only name will change, date will change, and the amount will change. Rest will be the same. So what is that? If I want to send any email notification, first I should have the predefined template. I should have what? Email templates. I should have email template. If I have the email template, then only I can go for email alerts. So now the discussion is, how do you create email templates? We will see email alert in the next session, but let us see how to create email templates. So let us go to the next action. So look at the format, email template. First, let us see how to create an email template. Look at the format, everyone. Setup, administer, then communication templates, then we have email templates. Setup, communication templates, email templates. All these are what? Standard templates which are created by the Salesforce. New template. Choose text or HTML. I will choose text. Enter the template name available for use. When I enable it, then only I can use this template. New customer acknowledgement, subject. Confirmation mail. Now what is that template name? Subject, then I'm giving it customer, your application form is approved and with the following details. Now in the email I have to send your data, right? Now, in the email, when I send an email to you, your data should be sent. When I send an email to me, my data should be sent. So, what should I do? I have to embed data of your record. Data of your record should be embedded here. So, what should I do? On the top, what we have? Merge fields. Merging the fields in the email. Merging the fields of a record in the email. Merging the fields of a record in the email. So, what I'm doing? Which object is this? Account. Which field you want to take? Copy this. Account name, industry, object name dot then we have created a mail. So this email will be sent to everyone where your name will be added, your industry will be added, your phone number. Workflow rule will be running on a record. Whichever the record on which the workflow rule is running, that record data will be added here. Are you getting my point? So first, before you send an email alert, we are supposed to create email template. We are supposed to create email templates. I hope you are good. Let me close up.